I think that madness is very interesting to look at as a category historically, because in many ways, what is considered mad is a mirror of what makes society uncomfortable. So, you know, in 1973, homosexuality was taken off the hit list, the DSM, or Diagnostics and Statistics Manual, hit list of the American Psychiatric Association. And, you know, thousands of homosexuals were cured of mental illness overnight. It was the most successful moment for mental health, really, historically. But similarly, as our notions of morality have changed, so too has society and the powers that be, you know, pathologization of women's morality has changed. You know, we're much more comfortable with the notion of masturbation. That used to be a sign of mental illness. I think that, however, now today we're pathologizing, and I see the psychiatric psych professions, broadly speaking, now looking very carefully at transgender behaviors, and I find it quite interesting the way in which they're being kind of conceptualized as mental health issues today.